Today on Upfront, rivals, friends, and frontrunners. Former Dane County Executive Kathleen Falk on her opponents and the quest to unseat Governor Walker.
Oh, we are all united here in our goal to win on June 5th and get our state back on track.
Plus, is the GOP strategy of placing protest or fake candidates on the ballot a crime? And Senator Ron Johnson on rumors of turmoil in his Capitol Hill office and the fight for what he calls the last shred of freedom in America.
We can choose to go down the path that President Obama is taking this country, which is one of a government-centered society, or we can choose a different path, a society based on opportunity.
It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. New ads, new endorsements, and a growing sense of urgency. Just some of the developments last week in the dash to determine which Democrat will face Governor Walker in the state's recall election. The Democratic primary is May 8th, the final election June 5th. The Walker campaign is already training its fire on two of the governor's potential opponents, slamming the records of Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett and former Dane County Executive Kathleen Falk on taxes, spending, and unemployment. Barrett and Falk are considered the frontrunners in the Democratic primary. We are joined today by the former Dane County Executive and Democratic candidate, Kathleen Falk. Thanks very much for being with us again.
Great to be here.
Let me have you begin by addressing the question that a lot of people are asking. Why do you feel you would be a stronger candidate against Scott Walker than Mayor Tom Barrett?
Well, you know, this is not a normal election. We have never seen anything like this in our state. And it's just regular, everyday people that have stepped over the last year and said, Governor Walker's not on our side. He's not fighting for our Wisconsin values. And I've been out there side by side with them this whole past year. And that's why all these wonderful organizations representing teachers and nurses and slow plow drivers, environmentalists, have all endorsed my campaign, from Sierra Club to the AFL-CIO and its 250,000 members just this week. And Voces de la Frontera, a wonderful Milwaukee group, just yesterday endorsing me.
So do you think Tom Barrett has not been there every step of the way?
Well, I sure have been. And I know that because, you know, I've heard the stories of citizens all across the state. And we want the same thing in Wisconsin. We want good schools for our kids, health care when we need it, a good paying job, and some clean air and water to enjoy with our families when we're not working. And Governor Walker has assaulted every one of those shared values.
Is it hard to differentiate yourself in this Democratic primary? I get the sense that there's sort of the Democratic version of Ronald Reagan's 11th commandment happening here. Thou shalt not speak ill of a fellow Democrat in this race. Does it make it hard to differentiate yourself from the three other major candidates when you don't want to be critical of your fellow Democrats?
Oh, we are all united here in our goal to win on June 5th and get our state back on track. But I have a track record, and that's why I have earned the endorsement of all these cross-section of organizations for whom Governor Walker, again, has assaulted our values, not producing the jobs he promised, rolling back our environmental laws, biggest cut in public education in our state's history, and throwing 35,000 men, women, and children off their health care. And that's why all these organizations representing all these values have endorsed my campaign. But then, you know, we saw that when Governor Walker's job agenda sadly failed our state and produced the worst job loss record of any state in the nation, he and the Republicans in the legislature then began the war on women. And that has not sat well with men and women in this state. It's the 21st century. And for them to roll back basic fairness like pay equity, where women are still paid only 81 cents to the dollar of men, and to roll back a law that gives a remedy against that kind of discrimination is not Wisconsin values.
Does that issue become a major theme in your campaign?
Well, I'm used to standing up for men and women. You know, I was an environmental lawyer helping citizens all around the state for 20 years. Born in Milwaukee, grew up in Waukesha. And then spent the last 14 years, you know, I've broken a lot of ceilings in my life. But you wouldn't think we're at that day and age now where we had to refight the same old battles. And there's men don't want their wives and sisters and moms and daughters treated unfairly. And us women certainly don't want to roll back the clock. And that's why I spoke out early and often over those last couple months when those awful bills were on the governor's desk for him to sign, and I urged him to veto, and he didn't.
You mentioned your 14 years in office as Dane County Executive. The governor's out with a new ad, and it targets your record, and it says that you raised property taxes 80% during your tenure, that you increased spending by 70%, that unemployment tripled. Is he wrong?
Hey, you got to chuckle. You just got to chuckle. You can't, you got to chuckle.
Wrong?
Sure, because look, here's what I've done. You know, under my 14 years as county executive, the longest serving there, I balanced a budget every year. I love doing it. It's the job of the top CEO, and I set a standard that I tried to keep our county to. And under my 14 years, Dane County had the highest job growth of any county in the state. I am proud of that record. I am eager to be a governor that rolls up her sleeves here, does the hard work of getting jobs in the state, unlike Governor Walker, whose theory, his big tax breaks for a few, and then the largest cut in public education in our state's history, painfully, sadly, did not work, because we've seen the
results.
And you
can make that judgment after 1 year that the policies have not worked, that
yes,
they will not work, and that there's no chance of them working.
Well, we can say that because it's the worst record of any state in the nation. And in contrast to the national economy, which is fortunately bouncing back, and our neighboring states are doing better.
Let me have you address this collective bargaining issue. You said you would veto the state budget if it did not restore collective bargaining provisions. That could result, obviously, in sort of a standoff, a game of chicken. How does that help heal the state, which you and other Democrats say we need to do?
Well, it's just the opposite of actually of what you may have suggested there, because there will be a Democratic Senate in the next couple months, and so there'll be a Democratic Senate and a Republican Assembly. And so there will be that inherent balance and tension. But in a democracy, that produces constructive negotiation and compromise, unlike what we have right now, which is a very extreme legislature and an extreme governor. And their extreme policies are why he's being recalled. And so the importance of restoring 50 years of workers' rights that built this middle class. I'm the granddaughter of a bus driver from Milwaukee. I have a better life because of what my grandfather's generation did. And so in order to restore those basic rights, you've got to have a governor who knows how to get it done. And introducing a bill will not happen. It will not make it happen because the Assembly Republicans won't act on it. Calling a special session will not make it happen because the Assembly Republicans won't convene. The only way to do it is through a budget bill. And unlike Congress, government continues in Wisconsin when there's to pass a budget bill. And so that's how you got to get it done. Unless you have a candidate who's open and honest about how they're going to do it and knows how to get it done, then it won't happen.
The mayor says the risk is that you reach a stalemate and the Walker budget continues indefinitely with the cuts to education, the cuts to local municipalities.
Just the contrary, because the stalemate will be between a Senate Democrat and the Assembly Republicans. And that's how you forge compromise. That's the beauty of our democracy. So that nobody has too much power, it makes people have to reach compromise.
Democratic candidate Kathleen Falk, we appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you.
Still ahead today, Republican Senator Ron Johnson will join us to talk about his high-profile role in the upcoming presidential election and about rumors about shakeups in his Capitol Hill office. And coming up, the ballot battle, the legal challenge to fake or protest candidates. Is faking it a crime? We'll be right back.
Upfront with Mike Boucher, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.